I'm here tonight at a spot that I've never really fished before. I used to fish in an old park that's to the side here that was shut down years and years and years ago. This is all real shallow water, and today was a warm day, so maybe some flatheads will be swimming through here. The sun would have definitely warmed up this water and maybe made them a little bit more active. Not sure how I'm going to have my rod set up. Maybe on the bait runner underneath the truck, because I want to get the two smaller rods out too. Maybe I can get a channel catfish if I can't get a flathead. Definitely going to make it difficult to film here. I don't have much space between me and the road and the water. Sometimes fishing in difficult spots can pay off. I have seen this area in the winter time, and there's dry land to the left. So I can't cast too far. Alright, we get to see if this new spot pays off. I really don't think I'm in the avenue, like a fish avenue. Ty with Effie Catfish, he once told me that catfish will get into a pattern of going down a certain highway. So if they're like over here, they will follow structure, follow the drop-offs, and just go in a certain pattern all the time. There'd be like a, you know, the catfish highway, and I don't think that would be over here. I think it would be on the other side, and the highway would literally here for like the flatheads to move around would be, I don't know, 2 football fields over there, and then they cross over towards one of my other spots over here and then make a curve and go along the bank that's way over there out to the channel and take a right around a point there, right where I was catching those, trying to figure out how to catch flatheads, which was literally right over there in my boat. There's the pole, I tie off to that pole, and there was like a log in the water that kept breaking off big fish. So I moved further and further away from it until I got a good flat area. And then I started actually catching some flatheads. Well, gotta turn that one on. Don't know if he's playing with it. Trying to do a live stream at the same time. So I'll probably be talking to the phone and talking to the camera. It's probably going to confuse everybody that's watching me live. Kind of reminded me of a flathead bite. Now that was the official first bite of the night. At least that I could see. If a bite happens on these and they don't get hooked up, I won't see it. Juggling cameras. Ugh. All right, let me look at the comments here. I do have a net with me. I've been using this net for my bank fishing adventures, specifically when I'm carp fishing. I leave the big monster rod holder's net on the boat and keep this with me. I used to keep this on the boat all the time as a secondary net because you can fold it, and it was perfect on the jet boat. I could keep it on there when I was, you know, fishing for crappie on the jet boat, and if I accidentally got a big flathead while crappie fishing, I could break out this net. But really, it's great for the bank because not only is it ginormous, huge, huge net. I mean, I could almost net myself in this thing. It also extends. There we go, that way. Right? Yep. So it extends way, way out. So I could net a fish pretty far out there. I don't know if I'd hold up a 100-pounder like this because it would bend it, but it would get it to the bank at least. And this net is not in the United States. This is a Savage Gear folding net, a telescoping folding net, the pro one or whatever. I bought it. Hair Sports Mail, I guess? I don't know. Maybe that's Canada. I bought it at some company in Europe for $40. And then paid another $40 to have it shipped to the United States. So this is pretty much $80. I like it. I think Fraybill might make a net like this now. I'm not sure. And at the time, I really couldn't find anything like it. And I was like, ooh, I want that. And I bought it. It was a one of those, you know, you gotta have it purchases that was actually worth it. Of course, I put it in the back of the truck where it's going to be impossible to reach if I get a big fish that I need to land with it. Oh, hey! Oh! There we go. Jumping down the water, it's so skinny. Cool, I am recording with the other camera. I'd say this is probably just a channel cat. Maybe it was whatever was messing with that other rod. Yep. Good old channel cat. One-aught team catfish, double action circle hook right here. Got them hooked really good. The fish that I caught on a live stream, and I'm talking to this camera instead of the people on the live stream. Let me show it to them as well. I don't know if it'll look better down here for you guys on the live stream. So I successfully caught something on a live stream. Hooray. Now you grow up to become a 20 pounder. Well, I can catch fish at this new spot. All right. Get this thing rigged up and send it back out there. Well guys, this video has already been all over the place. I was doing a live stream at the same time. I've actually stopped that live stream because I'm going to reel these up and move to a different spot to see if I can get another catfish on tonight's video. I have been here a couple hours already, so it's time to move. I should be at that spot in exactly 2 seconds. All right, here at a different spot with Skipjack on the menu. I think I put a head out at this spot. I didn't have a head out at the other spot. I don't have too much room at this spot either. The gut pocket actually fell out of this piece. My lines are going to be crossed five ways to Christmas. I might just put one of these out so I don't have too many lines crossing each other. Got a little bit of gut pocket to work with here too for the channel cat rod. Keep this stuff on ice. I don't have too much bait. Small piece of skipjack for the small fish rod. That goes to show, you could take one skipjack and load up your freezer with catfish. You really don't need more than one when you're cutting them up into itty bitty pieces and going for smaller fish like small blues or small channel cats. For the bigger fish, you can go through multiple skipjacks easily in one night. And you need bigger gear to be able to handle the bigger fish. So it's a lot easier just to use a Ceymar size 40 combo and go for small catfish. Easier to cook and less contaminants. Although I wouldn't recommend eating any of the small catfish out of this body of water just because of all the coal ash in the water. Every lake is different, so see what your wildlife agency says. Now maybe I can get one more fish tonight. I don't think it came out on camera, but there was a bunch of coyotes howling in the background while the sirens are going off. It's either ambulance or police cars or both. And they usually set off the coyotes. Channel catfish, maybe? I don't even know which one that was. Nope. Well, this is a really little one. They haven't been tearing it apart. I don't know. Maybe it's gar? I don't know if gar would be in this cold water. Even if it was a warmer day, this water's 50 to 60 degrees. I've already been here quite a while already. It's been, I don't know, another hour. Really nothing much is happening. It would be nice if whatever was grabbing this would have grabbed this instead, but they haven't. It is starting to get chilly and it's starting to get late. So I think I'm going to go ahead and call it and head back home. At least I caught a fish. Although it was kind of all over the place because I was live streaming at the same time. As always, I want to thank you guys for taking your time out of your day to watch my video. I really, really appreciate it. And if you do me a huge favor, hit that thumbs up if you like this video. I have some time off coming up, so maybe I'll be able to get a bunch of videos made and maybe land a big fish. Outside of a client catching a 30-pound flathead, I haven't caught a big fish for you guys in quite a while now. So maybe next time.